Hi guys, welcome back. This is Dave from MyGunValues.com. And today we're going to continue our series on the 375 H&H, and we're going to work on some reduced loads. I actually was planning on shooting, and once again, Mother Nature intervened, and we got 2 inches of rain in 12 hours, so I'm flooded again. It had finally dried out to the point I was going to get up the next morning and shoot. Didn't happen. So anyway, we're going to start off here with Accurate 5744 powder. It's a great powder for reduced loads. The way this works is you figure out where on the cartridge case the bullet's going to come up to. Okay, when you seat it, or down to. And it's going to come right down there to the base of the shoulder, more or less. So what you do, is you fill the cartridge case up. See if I can do this so you can see it. Fill the cartridge case up to the base of the shoulder with powder. Okay. We're full. Let's tap a little bit out there. Okay, right about there. And we come over here, and you see I've got my electronic scale on. We weigh that powder charge. You can see we come up with roughly 66.5 grains of powder. So the formula for 5744 is follows. You use 40% as a starting load of what your full case amount is. So if you have 66.5 grains, let's see, that would be 26.6 grains of powder. That would be our starting load. So what we're going to do here is we're going to climb the powder charge. And what I mean by that, and there's several different ways to word this. One of the ways to get your sweet spot for any cartridge and any load, especially when you're loading, you've got such a wide range. You know, I'm doing this in the wrong order. I'm so used to doing it, you know, just without thinking that I need to stop and slow down. 40% of the full case charge is 26.6 grains. Now the maximum would be 66.5 times 70%. That's what they say, never go over 70% of that full case charge, which would be 46.4 grains. I usually find about a 50% charge is somewhere in the ballpark. So what you're going to do, at least what I do, is now I'll talk about climbing that powder charge. What you do is you take one cartridge or one bullet, and you take the weight from the starting weight of 26.6 grains, and you bring it up half a grain at a time until you reach your full charge, which in this case I'm expecting to be somewhere around half, which is going to be basically 33 or 33.5 grains. You load one cartridge of each at, say, 26.6, and you load the next one at 27.1, 27.6. You load one of each. You have to make yourself a table as you do this. It's very important, because if you screw this up, all your data later is going to be useless. What you do is when you start shooting, you're going to find that somewhere in that sweet spot, the bullets are going to start clustering together, if that's a good load. And that's where you actually want to be. Let's say at 31 grains, 31.5 and 32, all my bullets end up in the same place, or very, very close, then we know somewhere in there is a sweet spot for that load. I keep in mind that on this one also we're looking for this a load that shoots the same point of aim as the 300 grain full house load for practice purposes. So what we do, I'm using an RCBS digital powder dispenser. See, it's 5744 powder. Go ahead and pour in a fair amount here. Then our starting load was 26.6. If we come back down here to the display, you see it says 26.6. Now, if you've ever used this thing, I really love this thing for extruded powders. It's slower than molasses in January for handguns, but for rifles, when you're doing experimentation like this, it's great. So, if you come back up here, you'll see this key right here that says dispense. Gee, which one do I use the most? All the black marks on it. I should mention, we're using CCI 250 large rifle Magnum primers. The Magnum primer is not necessary to light this amount of powder, but what I like is having that hotter spark to ignite the powder because it could be laying in any orientation inside the case because you're not coming even close to filling this case all the way full. So what you do is you hit the dispense key. Now this thing is going to dispense it'll count up to 26.5 grains, but that first one I always throw out because it's usually not accurate. So we put that back in the pan, or back in the hopper. We come back and we go 26.6, hit dispense again. This time it should come out pretty close. You let it count, comes back as 26.6 grains. Okay. Go ahead, pour it in. We come over here, and I know we're going to do a lot of camera flipping on this one. Let me get this zoomed in for you there. Okay. Now, we have a set of Lyman dies for 375 H&H. Let's see if that's showing up in the camera. So here I'm screwing that down in there. Okay, now, I've done this on other cartridges before, but I'm going to show you my trick. That one actually ended up seated too far, I do believe. And actually, it came out just about right. So now that I've got it about where I want it, you screw this top nub up. That lifts out the bullet seater on the inside of the die. You screw down the die. Okay, now we're getting tight. Now we're coming up against the neck of the case. I want to crimp these because when you're in a hunting situation, you know, your cartridges are getting bounced around. You always want to have just a little bit of a crimp on them. I don't need a lot, but just a little bit. Okay, so I've turned that down. Now I should have crimped that case neck. We've got just a little crimp on it. I don't know if this will show. There's a little ring right there where I've put a crimp on it. Okay, now I spin down the locking ring. Now the die is where I want it. There's an Allen screw on the other side here. I tighten that down. Then the bullet seater, I turn that back down until it contacts the bullet. Then I spin down this lock nut. Usually finger tight's good enough on those, especially when you're doing these experimental loads. Now we have a 26.6 grain load of accurate 5744. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to load up to that 33.6 we talked about. And if I'm right, that's 14 cartridges. And then I'll come back and I'll show you how I do these boxes of 50 when I'm doing experimentals so that you know... So you know which cartridge is which. And I'll load some of these up and we'll show you what we're doing. So I'm going to stop the cameras and then I'll come back and we'll show you what I've done and then we'll switch to a different powder because there's a couple of other powders you can use for this and their formulas aren't the same. So be back with you in a few minutes.